and look at that. This is actually my increasing function, strictly increasing. Look at that. Where, suppose I'm taking my x1 and x2. Here my f of x1. This is my f of x2. Okay, so look at that. My f of x1 is less than f of x2. So therefore, this is called as my strictly increasing function. Okay, so sometimes the curve may be like this. It is increasing and some stability, and again it is increasing. Okay, so this is simply because look at that. When I'm taking my x1 and x2, here both are equal. This is my f of x1. This is my f of x2. Okay, so here it is equal, but I'm taking my x1 and x2 here. My f of x1 and f of x2 less than f of x1 less than f of x2. Okay, so but for some interval it is equal, some interval it is less than. Therefore, this is called as my increasing function, only increasing, right? Similarly, for decreasing, suppose my function is coming like that, it is strictly decreasing. Okay, suppose my function is coming like that. And some stability and again coming down. Okay, so therefore this is called as only decreasing, not strictly. If for some interval my f of x values are equal. Okay, so therefore this is only decreasing, and this type of function, not decreasing, not increasing. Okay, here the function is decreasing, and here again it is increasing, again it is decreasing, again it is increasing. Okay. Right now, look at that. Suppose I am taking the point from this point to this point. Look at that. Suppose I am taking, this is my A, this is my B. Look at that. In this interval, my f of x is increasing. Look at that. In this interval, A comma B, my f of x is increasing, strictly increasing. See the curve? Right, from this interval. Similarly, from B to some point C, this is my C. From B to C, my function f of x is strictly decreasing. Are you okay? Are you understand? Okay, here it is going like this. Here it is going like this means, okay, so here up to minus infinity to A, look at that, minus infinity to A, my function is decreasing. And A to B, my function is increasing. And B to C, again, it is decreasing. My C to infinity, my function is, again, it is strictly increasing. Okay, but look at that, very important point. So in this interval only, function is increasing. In this interval only, function is decreasing. Okay, but entire domain, okay, my entire f of x is neither increasing nor decreasing. My total f of x, the entire f of x function is neither increasing nor decreasing because it is both are coming. Good afternoon, Stanley, Ganesh, everybody. Good afternoon. Okay, my entire function f of x is in the domain of f of x. My function is neither increasing nor decreasing, but in particular interval, my function is increasing and decreasing. Okay. Right. So how to check that the increasing decreasing is only the way is graph? No, we have some theorem. What is the theorem? My f of x is continuous and differentiable. That are the conditions. My f of x is continuous and okay. Your f of x is continuous on closed interval a comma b, differentiable and the open interval a comma b. My f of x is strictly increasing if my f dash of x is greater than zero. My f dash of x is greater than zero in the interval a comma b. My f of x is strictly increasing on a comma b means, okay, my f dash of x greater than zero in a comma b. My f of x is strictly decreasing, okay, on a comma b if my f dash of x is less than zero in a comma b. Okay, so what about my f dash of x is equal to zero, sir? my f dash of x equal to 0, then my f of x is a constant function. F of x is constant. This is a theorem result. Based on the result, we have discussed some problems also in our previous class. Today also we are going to discuss about some problems in the increasing and decreasing function. After that, we will go to that next topic, tangent and normal. Okay, so many problems we have discussed in increasing and decreasing. I have given homework problems also. Monday and Wednesday, you may get the homework problems in Max. Right. Okay, now look at that. Find the intervals. Find the intervals in which the following function are strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. Yes, any doubts? Homework for Monday and Wednesday. Dear students, Monday and Wednesday, you may get that Max homeworks, Monday and Wednesday. Today also. Today I have already sent the homework. You may get the homework, okay? Please look at that. Your internal mark is based on your homework and Saturday test, okay? Please, everybody do the homeworks and upload it. That is very important. And coming Saturday, we have a test in chapter number 5, continuity and differentiability, full chapter. Chapter 5, full chapter. Because last week the test cancelled. Okay, so therefore this week we are going to conduct the test in full chapter. Nagarjuna, full chapter. Chapter 5 full, okay. Right, now come to that. The function is, my f of x is equal to x plus 1 the whole cube into x minus 3 the whole cube. X plus 1 the whole cube into x minus 3 the whole cube. Right, what is my first step? You please try to understand the steps. What is my first step? My first step is find the derivative f dash of x. How to find the derivative for this one? There are two functions in multiplication. This is one is u, the another one is v. Okay. Apply uv formula. Right. So what is the differentiation of this u dash? My uv formula is differentiation of uv equal to u dash v plus uv dash. Are you okay? I'm going to apply my uv formula. U dash v, u means this is u dash differentiation. What is the differentiation of this x plus 1 the whole power 3? So that is 3 into x plus 1 the whole power 2, and differentiate this x plus 1. That is very important. Dy dx of this x plus 1 into x minus 3 the whole power 3 plus. My v dash, what is my, you keep it u as it is, x plus 1 the whole cube into, my v dash is 3 into x minus 3 the whole power 2 dy dx of x minus 3. That is differentiation of this x minus 3. What is the answer we are getting? 3 into x plus 1 the whole square. Okay, differentiation of x plus 1. What is the differentiation of x plus 1? So my differentiation of x plus 1 is 1 only. X differentiation 1, 1 differentiation is 0. And into this x minus 3 the whole power 3. Okay, plus. This is x plus 1 the whole power 3 into this is 3 into x minus 3 the whole square. What is the differentiation of x minus 3? This x minus 3 also x differentiation 1, 3 differentiation 0. So therefore into 1. So therefore, my answer is this is actually 3x plus 1 the whole square into x minus 3 the whole cube plus x plus 1 the whole power 3 into 3x minus 3 the whole square. Okay, in these two terms, which is common? Look at that. There are two terms. This is one term, this is another term. Okay, in these two terms, my 3 is common in both the terms. Similarly, here x plus 1 the whole square, here x plus 1 the whole cube. We can take it as x plus 1 the whole power 2 outside. And similarly, here x minus 3 the whole power 3, here x minus 3 the whole power 2. So therefore, I'm going to take 3 commonly. I'm going to take 3 commonly. X plus 1 the whole square commonly in both the terms. Similarly, x minus 3 the whole square also commonly in both the terms. What about the remaining 3 already taken? X plus 1 the whole square already taken. X minus 3 the whole power 3 already. X minus 3 the whole power 2 already taken. Remaining x minus 3 in the first term. Plus come to the second term. 3 already taken. X plus 1 the whole square already taken. X minus 3 the whole square already taken. Here actually x plus 1 the whole power 3 is there. But I have taken it as x plus 1 the whole square outside. So therefore remaining is x plus 1. So why you are doing all these things, sir? Because my first step is find f dash fx and factorize. I'm factorizing everything. That is my first step. My second step is let f dash fx is equal to 0. Okay? I understand? Right. Now what about here? This is my x plus x, 2x. This is my minus 3 plus 1, minus 2. So therefore, what is the answer? My answer is 3 into x plus 1 the whole square, x minus 3 the whole square, into that is 2x minus 2. Here you can take 2 outside. So therefore, already 3 is there. This is 3 into 2 into x plus 1 the whole square, x minus 3 the whole square, 2 already taken outside. Therefore, this is x minus 1. This is my f dash of x. So my first step is to find the increasing and decreasing function. My first step is find the derivative. Why, sir? Why you are finding derivatives, sir? Because look at that. This is a theorem. My f of x is strictly increasing on a comma b means, what is the condition? My f dash of x is positive. I am going to check at which interval my f dash of x is positive, at which interval our f dash of x is negative. For this particular interval, my f dash of x is positive, then I can conclude that for this particular interval, f of x is strictly increasing by this theorem. If my particular interval, in particular interval, my f dash of x is less than 0, negative, then I can conclude that my f of x is strictly decreasing at that same interval, particular interval a comma b, okay? Right, so therefore, to conclude strictly increasing or decreasing in particular interval, I need the value of f dash of x. That value of f dash of x is positive or negative in a particular interval. Sir, how to find out the interval, sir? So first of all, find f dash of x. And my second, factorize this. My second point is let f dash of x is equal to 0. Right? What is my f dash of x actually? 3 into 2, 6. This is x plus 1 the whole square. This is x minus 3. This is x minus 1 equal to 0, which implies, and do you know that actually this my x plus 1 the whole square is equal to 0. X plus 1 the whole square is equal to 0. X minus 3 the whole square is equal to 0. Or x minus 1 is equal to 0. So when you multiplying all the three terms is equal to 0 means either this must be 0 or this must be 0 or this must be 0. At least one of this term is 0. Okay, so therefore I'm taking that this is equal to 0, this is equal to 0, this is equal to 0. So then what happened? My x is equal to minus 1 here. So square is there, sir. Yeah, you take square root on both sides. Here x plus 1, root of 0 is again 0 only. I will get x is equal to minus 1. Here also, taking square root on both sides, I will get x minus 3 is equal to 0, my x is equal to 3. Here x is equal to 1. So therefore, the points of x are minus 1, plus 1, 3. I'm writing in order, that's all. Are you clear? Are you okay? This is my second step. So please try to understand, for any function they're asking increasing, decreasing means, then go for derivative, first derivative and factorize. Second step is take f dash of x is equal to 0, it will become an equation, either quadratic equation or cubic equation or fourth degree. Okay, so you will get an equation, right? So based on the equation, you solve the equation, you'll get some points. Based on these points, my third step, what is my third step actually? Based on these points, go to the number line. This is actually minus infinity to plus infinity. This is real number, minus 1. This is plus 1. This is 3. So look at that. Up to this, I am going to take one interval, minus infinity to minus 1. Okay, minus 1 to plus 1. Similarly, 1 to 3, 3 to infinity. I am going to take 4 intervals. So therefore, the intervals, and here sine of f dash of x, natural of f of x. Are you clear what I'm doing? What are the my intervals? Minus infinity, comma minus 1. Next minus 1, comma 1. And 1, comma 3. 1, comma 3 and 3, comma infinity. Okay, there are 4 intervals. Now check your sine of f dash of x. Sine of f dash of x means my f dash of x is positive or negative, plus or minus, greater than 0 or less than 0. That is going to check. How to check it? You can take any one point from this interval. You can take any one point. Don't take minus 1. This is an open interval. Open interval means minus 1 is not included. Okay, it is not possible to take minus 1 from this interval because it is not there. Minus 1 is not included. You take some other point, take minus 2. Okay, substitute here. This is my f dash of x. Okay, you write your f dash of x here also. What is your f dash of x? My f dash of x is 6 into x plus 1 the whole square, x minus 3 the whole square into x minus 1. This is my f dash of x. Okay, now substitute minus 2 here. When you're substituting minus 2 here, because it is square, minus 2 plus 1 means minus 1, but square means it will become plus 1, positive. This term is, I'm getting positive. What about here? Applying minus 2, minus 2 into minus 3, minus 2 minus 3 means minus 5. Minus 5 the whole square is also plus, because square is there. Okay, and when you apply minus here, minus 2 minus 1, what is the answer I'm getting? Negative. So therefore, plus into minus, my answer is negative minus. Are you okay? Are you understand? You please try to understand. Sir, why you are applying only plus, why you are putting only plus, only minus, sir? I'm going to find out the value, sir. Simplify this, sir. No problem. You just simplify. What is the answer you are getting? Suppose if you are confusing, you just substitute minus 2. Why you are choosing minus 2, sir? Can I choose minus 3? Yeah, you can choose it. You can choose any one simple point in this interval. You can choose any one point, but choose simple point. That is my advice. Simple point, minus 2. Don't choose minus 100, minus 150, minus 99. Don't choose like that. So if I am choosing minus 99, minus 100, minus 1000, what happens, sir? Again, you will get the same positive one, same negative only. So when I'm choosing minus 2, I'm getting negative, sir. But I'm choosing minus 99, I'm getting negative, sir. I'm getting positive, sir. It is not at all possible. Ganesh, you can choose any number from this interval. Ganesh, look at that. In this interval, minus infinity, comma 1, you tell me any one number. Minus infinity to minus 1, tell me any one number. Minus infinity to minus 1. Tell me any one number from minus infinity to minus 1. Choose minus 2, that's all. You have chosen minus 2, minus 3 and etc. Very good, Kanesh. My suggestion is, you please choose some simple number. My simple number is minus 2. You can choose -3 also. You can choose -4 also. You can choose -5 also. Sir, one student, my friend is choosing -4, sir. I am choosing -3, sir. But I am getting negative, sir. My friend is getting positive, sir. No, it is not at all possible. Are you okay? It is not at all possible. Please try to understand. Right? So for one value in this interval, I am getting negative, means for all other values also, I am getting my f dash fx is negative only. So see that this is 6 into, I am just substituting -2 here. -2 + 1, what is the answer? -2 + 1 means -1, -1 the whole square is 1. Here, -2, -3, -5. -5 the whole square is 25. -5 the whole square, that is +25. Here -2 - -1, okay, that is -3. Okay, when you multiply all these things, 6 × 1 × 25 × -3, I need the sign of f dash of x. I need the sign of f dash of x. Look at the theorem. I don't want the value of f dash of x. I want to know my f dash of x is positive or greater than 0 or less than 0. This is greater than 0 or less than 0. Look at that. Here I am getting greater than 0 or less than 0. When I am multiplying all these things, I am getting only my less than 0. This is less than 0. Am I right? Because minus sign is there. Less than 0 means, look at that, my f dash of x is less than 0 means my f of x is strictly decreasing. My natural f of x is strictly decreasing. Okay. Now come to that. The next number, you please tell me any one number from -1 to +1. Come to the next interval. Yes, that's all. Correct. Correct, Ganesh. Yeah, now take it 0. Take 0 and substitute here. 6 × 0 + 1. Okay, what is my 0 + 1? 0 + 1 the whole square is 1 only. And 0 - 3. -3, but -3 the whole square is +9. Not -9, +9 because square is there. Here apply 0. 0 - 1. 0 - 1, my answer is -1. Here also I am getting less than 0. Please see that some students are thinking, so first one is decreasing means that my second interval also, second interval increasing, sir, greater than 0, sir, third interval decreasing. Look at that, the previous problem, we have discussed so many problems, 4 to 5 problems. In all the problems, we are getting like that only. First interval decreasing means second interval increasing, and third decreasing, fourth increasing, alternatively. Look at that. It is not like that. It is not always possible. It is not always correct. Okay, look at that. In this interval also, my f dash of x is less than 0. In this interval also, my f dash of x is less than 0. Less than 0 means in this interval also, my f dash of x is strictly decreasing. Okay, right. Now come to that 1, 3. Yeah, tell me any one number from this 1, 3 here, taking 0. What about here? Any one value from this interval 1, 3? Yeah, take it 2. Very good. So I am taking 2. Substitute here. 6 × 2 + 1, 3² - 9. Here 2 - 3. I am substituting +2. 2 - 3 - 1. -1 the whole square is +1. Here 2 - 1. Okay, that is 1. Look at that. I am getting positive. Greater than 0. All are positive. 6 × 9 × 1 × 1. So that is 6 × 9 = 54. That is greater than 0, positive. Okay, so therefore, this is strictly increasing. Okay, right. Now come to that. The next. take 4, substitute here, 4 plus 1 the whole square, 5, 4 plus 1, 5, 25, okay. And 4 minus 3, that is 1, 1 square, 1. Okay, here also 4 minus 1, 3 into 3. Okay, so now look at that, all are positive. So therefore, this is also positive. My function is strictly increasing. Are you clear? Are you understanding? Right, so this table itself gives the answer. So the table gives all our required answers. You please put the table, use pencil scale for table. Okay, right, the conclusion is, this is the conclusion. If you want, write the conclusion like that also. So f of x is strictly increasing. Sometimes we use the arrow mark, but in your exam you don't write arrow mark. Don't write arrow mark. Okay, you please try to understand increasing mean this is a arrow mark symbol, increasing symbol. Okay, strictly increasing on 1, 3. On 1, 3 and 3, infinity. Okay, similarly, and my f of x is strictly decreasing. The symbol is down arrow mark on -infinity, -1 and -1, 1. Okay, yeah, please take that. If you have any doubt, please ask your doubts. I will explain one more time. Otherwise, if you don't have any doubt, means we'll go to the next problem. Shall we move to the next one? Are you completed? Ganesh, what is your question? Second part, negative. Dear students, look at that. These are my x values. Okay. Ganesh, do you know this parabola? Suppose here I am taking -2. Here I am taking -1. Okay, so in -2, -1, my function is increasing or decreasing? From the graph, you tell me. In -2, -1, this is negative, Ganesh. As you told, based on your doubt, this I am taking the negative interval. Okay, in this interval, your function value is, function is increasing or decreasing. This is my f of -2, this is my f of -1. This is increasing or decreasing, Ganesh? In this interval, particularly this interval, -2, -1. Yeah, dear students, please try to understand. increase only. Look at that, it is increasing. My interval length, interval is negative interval. Yes, minus 2 comma minus 1. Okay, that means the x values, actually this is not a negative interval. My values of x is negative. My values of x is negative, but you are increasing, decreasing, not depending upon your x value, not depending upon your f of x value. Please try to understand, Ganesh. You are increasing and decreasing, not depending upon your x, not depending upon your f of x. Okay, it is depending upon your f dash of x. If my f dash of x is positive in particular interval, my f of x is increasing. F of x is increasing. My f dash of x is negative, less than zero. Okay, my f of x is decreasing. Are you clear, Ganesh? So therefore, it is, you don't conclude anything based on x, or x is negative, sir. Then how can you tell that, sir, it is increasing or decreasing? My f of x is negative, sir. Here, look at that, my f of x value is negative. Okay, so therefore, based on f of x, we are not concluding. Based on x, we are not concluding. Based on f dash of x, we are concluding. Why, sir, you are using f dash of x? That is a theorem. This is a theorem. See your book. One important theorem is given. My f of x is strictly increasing on the given interval means if my f dash of x is greater than zero, my f dash of x is positive in a particular interval. My f dash of x is decreasing means my f dash of x is less than zero in that particular interval. Based on the theorem, I'm concluding everything. Okay, not by x, not by f of x. Okay, don't think about that. Here, some of the students here, my x value is positive means they are thinking that f of x is positive. My x value is negative means my f of x is negative. It is not like that. It is not possible. This is the example. Here, look at that. This is my 1, this is my 2. X belongs to 1 comma 2 positive values. My f of x is, look at that, both are negative. My f of x value is both are negative and it is decreasing also. My x is positive, my f of x is negative and my f of x is decreasing. See the curve. From the diagram, I'm concluding curve, but it is not possible to draw the curve for every given expression. So that's why I'm going for some mathematical method. Based on the derivative, I'm finding that the function is increasing or decreasing in a particular interval. Are you clear? Are you okay, Ganesh? Now look at that, find the values of x. For which y is equal to x into x minus 2 the whole square is an increasing function. Okay, find the values of x for which y is equal to x into x minus 2 the whole square is an increasing function. For which value or which interval the function is increasing? That is the question. What is my first step? Finding f dash of x. Okay, before going to find the f dash of x, first of all, you simplify this. Y is equal to, or my f of x is equal to x into x minus 2 the whole square. Am I right? This is actually x square minus 2x the whole square. You multiply this x and x minus 2. This is your f of x. Now find out your f dash of x. Actually, what is your f dash of x? 2 into x square minus 2x into, that is, I am applying that x power n formula. You consider this is your x power n formula. 2 into x square minus 2x power 1 and differentiation of this d by dx of this x square minus 2x, 2x minus 2. Okay. Differentiation of x square minus 2x So what is the answer? 2 into x square minus 2x. The definition of x square minus 2x is 2x minus 2. So now what is my answer? Here I can take x commonly. This is my x minus 2. Here I can take 2 commonly. That is x minus 1. So therefore the answer is 4 into x minus 1, x minus 2. My first step is differentiate and factorize. Differentiate and factorize. That is my first step. There are 3 steps. What is my second step? Let f dash of x is equal to 0. What is my f dash of x? This is my f dash of x. What is that? 4x into x minus 1, x minus 2 equal to 0. Okay, and find the x values. So actually this is my 4x is equal to 0 here. My 4x is equal to 0, or x minus 1 is equal to 0, or x minus 2 equal to 0. Why, sir? So when you multiply these 3 terms, we are getting 0. Okay, suppose my x into y into z is equal to 0 means what is the meaning? Either x must be 0 or y must be 0 or z must be 0, or at least any one is 0. At least any one. Both may be 0 or all the 3 may be 0. But at least one 0. If x, y, z is not 0, sir, but I'm multiplying all the 3, I'm getting 0. Sir, it is not at all possible in real numbers. In real numbers. So in some other places it is possible, sir. Yes, it is possible in matrices. 2 non-zero matrices, multiplication may be 0. Okay, but that portion is deleted from your chapter portion. No problem. If any one is 0, 4x is 0 or x minus 1 0, x minus 2 equal to 0, the conclusion is my x is equal to 0, here x is equal to 1, here x is equal to 2. So therefore my x value is equal to 0, 1, 2. This is my second step. Go third step, go to the number line, real numbers. I'm going to the real numbers number line. So taking minus infinity to plus infinity, this is my 0. Mark 0, 1, 2, everything. Zero, one, two. Right now come to the intervals. What are the intervals? Intervals, sine of f dash of x, nature of f of x. What are the intervals? My intervals is, first interval is minus infinity, comma, 0. Next interval is 0, comma, 1. And 1 comma 2 and 2 comma infinity. Okay, take one point from this interval and substitute in f dash of x. Actually, what is your f dash of x? This is my f dash of x. My f dash of x is see that my f dash of x is equal to 4x into x minus 1, x minus 2. This is my f dash of x. In this f dash of x, I'm going to substitute any one value, at least one value in this interval. Don't take 0, it is open interval. Open interval means don't include 0. Don't take 0, take any one. Yeah, minus 1, take it. Apply minus 1, Ganesh. What happened? 4 into minus 1. My x is minus 1. Here minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Now look at that. This is positive or negative? Minus into minus plus, plus into minus minus, that is less than 0, negative. Okay, less than 0. Less than 0 means what is my conclusion by the theorem? If my f dash of x is less than 0, my f of x is strictly decreasing. So this is strictly decreasing. Okay, come to the next one. Take a one point from this one. Any one point from 0, 1. 0, 1. Yeah, you take 0.1. I am taking 0.1. Here I am taking -1. Here I am taking 0.1. Apply 0.1. 4 × 0.1. In place of x, I am applying 0.1 - 1. Okay, so what is the answer? -0.9. +0.1 - 1. Okay, -0.9. Here 0 + 0.1 - 2. So therefore -1.9. Okay, this is positive or negative? Look at that. Minus into minus, it is plus. Here positive, this is positive. Minus into minus, it will become positive. So therefore, it is greater than 0. Positive value. I am getting positive value. I need only sign of f dash of x. I don't want the value of f dash of x. I need only the sign of f dash of x. My sign of f dash of x is positive. That is greater than 0. So therefore, my f of x is strictly increasing. Dear students, please try to understand. Based on the sign of f dash of x, we are concluding my f of x nature, increasing or decreasing. Okay. Now come to this 1, 2. Tell me any one point from this 1, 2. In this interval, I am taking any one point. Yeah. What is the answer? Yeah. Take it 1.1. Apply 1.1. 4 × 1.1. This is 1.1 - 1. My answer is 0.1. This is 1.1 - 2. So that is -0.9. 1.1 - 2. That is -0.9. So here, look at that. This is positive. This is positive. This is positive. This is only one negative. One negative means my final answer is also negative. Okay, less than 0. So therefore, this is strictly decreasing. Okay, right. Now tell me any one value from this interval. Any one value from this interval, 2, ∞. Yeah, take it as 4. I am taking 4. You can take 3 also. Sir, why you are missing 3, sir? No problem. You can take 3 also or 4 also. Right? I am taking 4. So 4 × 4. This is 4. And this is 4 - 1. 3. This is 4 - 2. It is 2. Look at that. This is positive. This is positive. This is positive. This is positive. If you multiply all the 4 numbers, I am getting a positive value. If I'm getting a positive value, my f of x is strictly increasing. Are you clear? Are you okay? Are you understand? So complete the table. Right, what is the conclusion? My conclusion is my f of x is decreasing in -∞, 0 and 1, 2, and increasing in 0, 1 and 2, ∞. That is my conclusion. So come to the conclusion. So the conclusion is my f of x is f of x is strictly increasing on 0, 1, 2, ∞. Increasing on 0, 1, and 2, ∞. And f of x is strictly decreasing. On -∞, 0 and 1, 2. Are you okay? Are you clear? So look at that. Ganesh, don't get the confusion about the graph and the interval. Okay, here both are my x value, not y values. If you have x comma y, you can plot the values and connect the values. Okay, you will get the graph. Suppose if you know 2 comma 3, 5 comma 4, Ganesh, these are the points, but this is called as intervals. Please try to understand the difference between the point and the interval. Okay, point means in coordinate geometry we are representing 2 comma 3. That means one single point in coordinate geometry. This is 2, this is 3. This is the point, Ganesh. The single point 2 comma 3, it is not an interval. In coordinate geometry, okay, coordinate geometry we are using this. But in intervals means 2 comma 3 intervals means in a number line in x-axis, okay, you have to take all the points. You are considering all the points from 2 to 3. How many points are there 2 comma 3, Ganesh? How many points are there in 2 comma 3? In 2 comma 3, how many points are there between 2 comma 3? Interval. Interval. What are that? That is 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5, 2.6, 2.7, 2.8, 2.9. Am I right? What about 2.11, Ganesh? This is not in our 2 and 3, 2.11. This 2.11 belongs to this 2 and 3 or not? 2.1111. 2.010101, 2.511515. Okay, all these points are in between these 2 and 3 only. Okay, not 10 points. This is undefined points, infinite number of points. This 2 comma 3 interval contains infinite number of points, not 10 points, not 5 points, infinite number of points, real numbers. I am speaking about the intervals. Okay, so therefore in intervals 2 comma 3 means it contains infinite number of values that are called as, we can take it as that are x. Okay, so here 2 comma 3 means, okay, in coordinate geometry 2 comma 3 means it representing only one point. This is not an interval, this is a point. But here this is not a point, this is an interval. Okay? And both the values are both my x, 2 and 3 representing only x, not y. Okay, my f of x is my y. If you are applying some f of x value, that is my y. Are you clear? Are you understand? Okay. Right, now come to that, the next one. Any other doubts, dear students, any other doubts? Yes, Rama, in my interval, I am taking any one value, that's all. In the given interval, you take any one value and apply in f dash of x and check that is negative or positive. Based on that, I am concluding that my f of x is increasing or decreasing. Are you okay, Rama? So in place of, I am taking minus 1. If you are taking, if you want minus 2 means, if that minus 2 belongs to that interval means you can take it, no problem. You can take any one point from that interval. Okay. Right now come to that, show that. y is equal to log of 1 plus x. I hope that this problem not completed till now. 2x by 2 plus x. My x greater than minus 1 is increasing function of x throughout its domain. Is an increasing function. Is an increasing function of x throughout the its domain. Okay, right, now come to that. That is increasing, decreasing. Increasing, decreasing means you have to follow three steps. What are the three steps? First of all, find f dash of x. Second step, take f dash of x is equal to 0 and find the points of x. Based on that, split into intervals and find that which interval function is increasing, which interval function is decreasing. Okay, what is my first step? Derivative. Find the derivative. What is my derivative of log of 1 plus x? That is 1 by 1 plus x. Log x, differentiation. And differentiate this 1 plus x also. 1, 0, x is 1. Log x differentiation is 1 by 1 plus x into this 1 plus x differentiation is 1 differentiation 0, x differentiation is 1. Okay, but come to here, you have to apply u by v formula. Okay, what is my u by v formula? My u by v formula is u dash v minus u v dash by v square. What is my u? This is my u, this is my v. Apply u by v formula. So this is minus my u dash. You take minus commonly. My u dash means u dash differentiation, 2x differentiation is 2 only. My v is 2 plus x minus 2x into my v dash differentiation is 2, 0, x, 1 whole divided by 2 plus x the whole square. Okay, so therefore my answer is this is 1 by 1 plus x minus this is 2 into 2, 4 and 2 plus 2x. This is minus 2x whole divided by 2 plus x the whole square. This 2x, 2x get cancelled. I am getting minus 4 divided by 2 plus x the whole square. Are you okay? Are you clear? So therefore, my f dash of x is equal to 1 by 1 plus x minus 4 divided by 2 plus x the whole square. You just take a cross multiplication. This is 2 plus x the whole square minus 4 into 1 plus x. I'm just taking the cross multiplication. Okay, divided by my 1 plus x, 2 plus x the whole square. So this is apply a plus b the whole square formula. A square plus b square plus 2ab minus, multiply this minus 4 inside. Minus 4 minus 4x whole divided by 1 plus x 2 plus x the whole square. Okay, so now this is actually my plus 2 square minus 2 square cancel. This is 2 into 2 4x plus 4x minus 4x cancel. Okay, I am getting only my x square by 1 plus x 2 plus x the whole square. Okay, look at that. The question is, look at my question. My function is increasing. Show that the function is increasing throughout the domain. Okay, so what is my domain? My domain of f of x is, my domain of f of x equal to, that is minus 1 to infinity. Why, sir? Because it is given. What is given? My x is greater than minus 1 is given. greater than minus 1 means more than minus 1, minus 1 to plus infinity. This is my domain of f of x. So therefore, here only my x belongs to. Okay, my x belongs to this interval only. That is the domain of f of x. Okay, right. Now come to that. When x greater than minus 1, okay, please come to this f dash of x. My x greater than minus 1, my x square is equal to positive. This term, x square is equal to positive. This 2x, 2 plus x the whole square is positive. Okay, what about this 1 plus x? This 1 plus x is also positive. Why? When my x is equal to my x greater than minus 1 or x belongs to this domain, my x square is positive. Why? Because every square term is positive. Minus 1 the whole, minus 0.5 the whole square, 0 the whole square, 1 the whole square, minus 0.1 the whole square, everything will become positive. Here also square is there, it will become positive. But here there is no square, but how you are concluding that it is positive, sir? Look at that, my x is greater than minus 1. Greater than minus 1 means your x value, the minimum x value is minus 1 only, minus 0.9999, like that, okay? So if you apply my x is minus 0.9, again 1 minus 0.9, I'll get plus 0.1, positive only. So therefore, which implies my f dash of x is x square by 1 plus x, and this is 2 plus x the whole square. This is positive, look at that. This is positive, this is positive, this is positive. All the three terms are positive. My f dash of x is also positive, or greater than 0. For every value of x, no interval, for all x, my x f dash of x is positive. Okay, which implies my f dash of x is positive for all the values of x, my f of x is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing for all x greater than minus 1. Okay. Any doubts? You please ask your doubts. If you have any doubt, you please ask your doubts. Students, if you have any doubt, you please ask your doubts. Today I have sent the homework problems. You please work out the homework problems. 4 to 5 homework problems already given. In this increasing and decreasing function only, you please try. Try to complete their homework problems and upload it properly. You upload today itself. Some students are waiting for tomorrow and day after tomorrow. It is not possible to upload. Your time will bar. Okay, so therefore you please apply today itself. Right, any other doubts? And dear students, you please take a notes properly. Okay, everybody, you please write the notes properly. That is a very important one. Okay, thank you all, thank you, Rivan. Thank you so much. Are you okay? Are you clear? So, please, my humble request is please complete the homework problem and upload it. Okay. And coming Saturday, full chapter test, 5th chapter, full test, Saturday. Please try to get good marks. Okay. Okay, thank you all. Thank you so much.